using the wireless scoring system here tonight, and the technicians out putting the wireless attachment on.
I have to say that if you read your form book, you'd favour Yannick Borel here, and let me tell you why. 7 competitions so far this season, major ranking events. 5 of them have been won by French fencers, and 5 different French fencers. Yannick Borel is not one of those 5. He came 2nd in Heidenheim, lost to Max Heinzer, funnily enough, in the final there. So if you look at that kind of form, I know that's a very simple way of putting it, but is there going to be a 6th different French winner of the major championships this year?
We shall see. Juan Carlos Rios Rivera, our referee for this match. And the clock didn't start, so we reset and begin again. Well, the round of 16 today was, I think, a devastating one for what has been an incredibly successful French Épée squad. They came in with 5 fencers, and only Yannick Borel came out alive. Grumier, Robéry, Lucenay, and Gustin all out in that round of 16. But Yannick Borel can make up for all that right here.
Well, like I say, he came 2nd in Heidenheim back in January. Had a 32 in the Grand Prix in Budapest, and those are the notable results for his season. Only 2 16s for Zvotniak in Bern and Vancouver, and 3 64s to add a couple more points to his ranking.
Quite a move there from Zvotniak. He's continuing the form he's shown all day.
Well, lefty versus righty in this occasion. The right-hander picked up circular season, flicked over the top of his opponent's wrist. Nice move there. Gentleman here from Yannick Borel. His blade was picked up in octave by Zvotniak, and that forced his point down onto the carpet just surrounding the piece. And he indicated that to the referee, so no hit given there.
Another significant difference in height and size here on the piece. Borel looks like he's about a head taller than Zvotniak.
Yeah, one's tall and the other one's taller. No hit will stand there. Zvotniak is now asking the referee if he should bring out a card for barging, and sent the referee to look at the video.
Let's see if we can get a look here. No.
I'd be very surprised if a card is awarded for that. Borel did come steaming forwards, but his opponent fell over in front of him, and he had no way of stopping.
Well, nothing given.
temperature's just gone up.
Yeah, fantastic blade action. But it is Burrell who comes out with the point. Good reaction there from Zabrotniak. Well, Radoslav Zabrotniak seems to have found his form here. That will take us to the end of the opening period. 3-3, Zabrotniak, Burrell. And I felt like Burrell really had Zabrotniak's number, even if he did not have a huge point margin. But Zabrotniak closed that first period well.
Yeah, it's same as the first fight, where Heinze went out into an early lead, but was pegged back by the time we got to the first break. Same things happened here. First 3 minutes is always about feeling out what your opponent's doing, even if you know your opponent well. And these two, in fact, have met this season back in Heidenheim. And it was Burrell that beat Zabrotniak there, but that was in the pools when they only fenced up to 5 hits.
We can see that on the replay there with Zabrotniak going to the floor. And we are ready now to start our second period in our second semifinal match. We're coming to you live from Rio de Janeiro, the 2015 Rio Grand Prix.
Combativity.
Well, we roll on to the third. And there will be no break. They'll simply reset the clock. And we'll see if we can make it through the third, or if we take this three into a non-combativity priority minute. Double there.
Smart work from Zabrotniak. He's not going to let this one just peter away and go into a non-combative priority minute. But to be fair, I don't think Yannick Burrell is as well.
I feel like Yannick Burrell is really pressing and trying to score. Now he needs to.
Is if they just keep trading hits, as they have done so far in this period, it's a matter of how long before they say, all right, okay, let's take it to that Let's take the risk of a non-combativity priority minute.
Vrotniak asking the referee for permission to remove his mask and wipe his face. It is not overly warm here in this hall in Rio, but if you're under those lights and in that kit and have the pressure of a semifinal match on you, it can get pretty warm.
The referees have been consistent throughout the day. In line, that's a nice hit from Burrell. Takes the blade, closes out, goes into the low line. Yeah, the referees have been a little bit more lenient. It has been a little muggy today. I walked over to the other hall and it was pretty hot in there, I have to say. And like you say, with the lights on them as well. I'm not surprised that the referee has allowed him to wipe his face. But while saying all that, Yannick Burrell has clawed back that two-hit deficit.
Double there.
This is becoming an intriguing battle.
Referee calls halt as they came together. What an exchange, and it is Burrell taking the lead now. What is Zvrotniak have to say to the referee? Is he asking for it to be checked? He does.
Yeah, it's that sort of last chance, last hope. Please make my épée not work, please.
And for those not familiar, if that weapon does not work, then the hit is annulled.
Yep.
Is that correct?
It is indeed.
Lovely, lovely hit from Zvrotniak. Now Zvrotniak presses. Burrell takes his blade, scores. And Zvrotniak needs to be careful not to walk into those. And he makes that one work. A word there from Juan Carlos Rios Rivera. And not sure what the warning was for. Do you have any?
He might have said something to his opponent. No sledging allowed in fencing. And the referee is, I don't think he was asked to go and look at the video, but he was convinced enough by Zvrotniak's reaction that hit may well have been on the floor, but I don't think it was. It's just such super fast handwork from Burrell. He was able to get parried and then action himself, but the hit doesn't stand. It has been taken off the scoreboard. Didn't get a good enough look at the replay.
Well, earlier in the match, Burrell went off the, or hit off the side of the piece and acknowledged that, but that action was so fast that it would have taken a replay to determine.
See Burrell trying to find a way through. He's looking to get a reaction out of Zvrotniak. Eventually he gets the one he wants and launches his attack.
Well, You mentioned so often the importance of that explosive speed in situations like that, and that was a perfect, perfect execution. And this time, Zavratniak pressing, Borel stepping back, drawing him in, and then picking him off.
Pole has to go for it now. He's taken out the hoardings on his way off the piste. And to make matters worse, he got hit.
So close for Radoslav Zavratniak. And that will do it. Yannick Borel of France will fight for gold. 15-11 over a very talented and very game Radoslav Zavratniak. He can only be pleased with his performance today. And he came out there looking like he wanted gold.